We'll do it live.
Here we go. Broadcasting live.
Are we getting good levels?
Across Sydney.
Satellite.
And around the world.
We put on have a show.
Kyle and
Jackie O dominated the airwaves.
Kyle Sandivans rolled up in his Bentley to visit his mate.
The Kyle and Jackie O Show.
Kyle and Jackie O, the new king and queen of Britain.
Speaking during an appearance on the Kyle and Jackie O Show.
Radio DJ Jackie O.
Sandilands and co-host Jackie O have just signed an astonishing deal.
Kyle and Jackie O.
On the Kyle and Jackie O Breakfast Show. The world's biggest breakfast show.
Over in Australia.
A show in Australia called the Kyle and Jackie O Show.
I'm seeing stars.
It's Demi Lovato.
If aliens came, would you have sex with the alien?
I said I would have to get to know him for a few days first. The question is, would you, Demi?
I already answered it. I said yes so fast.
Henry Golden, you're a very good-looking man. You must look in the mirror and say, yeah, I gotta
talk to you guys more often.
Hey, this is Ava Max, and I'm hanging out with Kyle and Jackie O.
Oh, my God, a glitzy microphone.
And the gold, and I'm done.
$50,000.
Oh, my God.
$100,000. You have won the house.
Ella Jones, I only listen to Kyle and Jackie O.
Live on the iHeart Radio app.
We can get it started, let's go.
The Kyle and Jackie O Show is just one big party.
You're listening to the boy from the big bad city.
Listening to another station at 6 a.m. is like dog shit.
How does a penguin build its house?
It's an igloo, right?
I think you'll find the humans live in the igloos.
The golden microphone is on. It's Friday.
Friday.
Hello. Hello.
You know what makes this weekend even more special is that the light is here.
The light.
The light. Yeah, for
You're
Monday.
Dying.
No.
Oh, the what is that Monday? You guys get
Freedom
to
Day.
That's right.
Sunday is our last day of lockdown.
That's it.
Hopefully
doesn't feel
ever.
like a weight has been lifted.
I've got to say, it feels no different to me.
Oh, I just
you know
can't
I've been pull. Doing whatever, and I've been sort of playing by the rules.
No, before lockdown, Kyle, you were going to restaurants with your friends. You were doing things.
I'm still doing that.
There were no restaurants open.
Yeah, they are for us.
Oh, right, down at I won't say where.
We get them opened, and we go in, we eat, we go out. But you got to live life still in amongst all this rubbish. But you're right. For the majority of people,
we haven't
life
been
will
able
be good.
To go.
Well,
to
you're
a restaurant.
You're real followers, and you all line up. Like, even I'd take Jackie overseas, Brooklyn, and I'd say, "Look, we're going backstage at the Grammys. Oh, we can't. We're not allowed that. We don't. Our passes aren't." I said, "Listen, just follow me."
What a lie!
Backstage, I'd take.
What a lie,
Kyle!
Not a lie.
Doing things where like the general public is not allowed anyway.
That's right. I like doing that.
I love that. Mixing and meeting new people.
Not me. I can't stand it.
Kyle. You got that story completely wrong.
What is the story? I know we were backstage.
Yes. Now this was
it. How did we get there?
This is back in the day. We're going back to when I told you that goes the story and about the MTV red carpet where we were brutal. Well, no, I was brutal and Kyle.
That's right. And
Kyle
I was
saw
in
me.
Shock the way she was carrying on like some sort of foreign spy.
Yeah, so he was shocked at how aggressive I was on the red carpet in getting stars. And it was all around that period. And so Kyle was still new-ish. And
yeah, very new, very wide-eyed.
He hadn't gone to these things before. And then I was the one that said, let's just go backstage. You know, if we own it, we'll go backstage. We went backstage and you said, oh, I don't know that we should be here.
Oh, my
here.
God, she's taking my story and claiming it to be her own.
It is. And then after
they say this happens to people.
Yeah, but it is the story. And then after it somehow swapped over the years where you became the one that was, we're doing this, we're doing that. Because you learnt from the best.
I did. You were very good at this. You knew. I used to look at you and think, like, obviously jerking off constantly to you and stuff before I ever met you. Then when I met you, I thought, she's right here. I could probably get this. I don't want to go into details about whether that did or didn't happen over the 21 years. It's
Kyle,
no one's business.
It's
no one's business. Jackie, you're right. Some things need to be kept personal. And then there's sex, and then there's full sex, half sex. Is that even sex?
There was no, Kyle, don't put that out there.
A million shades of grey around, you know?
Oh, dear.
But you have been, and I have always admired you and thought that you were great, a great broadcaster. Even during your fattest days, I still, there was a slither of admiration still there.
Well, see, you only like me based on my weight.
No, no.
Or admire. Based on
No.
What you just said.
Not
a
really.
A slither of that was admiration.
Me. That was just me being a bit nasty.
Ah, that's okay.
You admire great, though, Jackie. There's not many people, male or female, who've had success for as long as you. Right?
Wow, you're doesn't up there. She sound like an old granny? That
I'm proud of that.
No, well, you should
be proud.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I am. And as big a success as you've been in your career, like, so it balances out the utter failure with the personal relationships in your life.
Well, you know what they say, you can have it all, but not all at once.
That's right, Jackie. And you've had penis before, so now it's about career.
No, it's about, I don't know what it's about. Career is definitely up there.
Well, you can't take your eye off the career.
Yeah, the career is like, you know, obviously got that. So that's good. Got the beautiful child.
Mm.
Got a nice place to live in.
Yeah, now we're in there.
But no one.
Well, someone to share it with.
Just a big, thick dose of love. No, no, love. Wow. There's some honesty. We're doing tradie versus lady. Yesterday it was left where the tradies were just being defeated by the ladies by 1 point. Quite unfair, I feel, because I gave them an extra point, remember?
You did. You were being kind.
Doesn't happen often.
It doesn't. So now we're on 76 and you're on 75.
Right. We need a tradie. We need a lady. Ring up right now, 131065. Today also, Jack is going to be putting things in her mouth.
Yes.
We'll guess what it is. The pop quiz is there. The diary's there. The credit card's coming out. Jackie's got more pen pals from prisoners.
Yes, so excited.
Hey, what's that thing, Mayo, that someone's going to do a psychic assessment? I heard the ad.
Not a psychic assessment, a psychiatric assessment.
Oh, psychiatric.
Yeah.
How I came in the other day, asked you a series of questions.
Oh, yeah, I hated that. That were the dumbest questions. I was very agitated.
I know, you hated it. Jackie didn't mind it. And now we have the results live. So the psychologist will come on and explain what your results are. Who's more sane and stable?
Who's more sane? Shut up, Lockie. You're in the background, bitch.
Right,
I do like you, Lockie. He might burst into tears because he doesn't understand humour.
Sorry, I was just starting to ring up for tradie versus lady.
Yeah. Just talk, mumble quietly to them on the phone in the background when Mayo's on air. No need to yell out like that. So the doctor will tell us who's more mental, or what's the idea here?
Well, he helps cast for Survivor and SAS. So he sees whether they're capable.
Do you not hear the question I ask?
Well, I was saying yeah. Like, he was saying...
No, you didn't say yeah. That's the bit I want.
I was getting to that part. I was saying who's more stable and would be able to succeed in a military scenario.
Who gives a shit
based
about
off
the military?
I don't care about the military. Personality traits. That's how I was going to explain. Anyway.
I wish you could just kill people at work you didn't like.
Oh, just like in Squid Game.
Yes, exactly like
look,
in Squid Game.
Point and done.
Yeah.
That would be dangerous. We'd
have
no
them licking
left.
A biscuit and stuff. Yeah, who cares? And when you get towards the end of the year, you get over people. You know, I suppose if you've been in lockdown and stuff like that, you're missing your work colleagues. Well, not here. Absolutely not.
Okay. All right, let's do Tradie vs. Lady. You will win a smart home bundle by Amazon Alexa, including the all-new Echo Show 10 and the Fire TV stick. It's
good
a great
stuff.
Price.
You want it? Ring up now. 131065 is the number. DJ XXL over in LA. Kicking things off for a Friday morning, everyone. He's back at 8 and then back at lunchtime as well. 3, 2, go, big fella.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Here we go. Gather round, everyone. Tools down if you've even had the worksite yet. If you win today, you win the smart home bundle by Amazon Alexa, including the all-new Echo Show 10 and Fire TV stick. You're ready to meet today's contestants?
Sure.
Let me introduce everyone to Franco. Is it Franco? Is it Franco?
Francois.
Oh, God. Is that how you spell Francois? I've never written that down before. What a fancy name. Francois, good morning. Playing for the tradies, everyone. He's been an electrician for 13 years, married with three lovely daughters, drives around in a white Ford Ranger, so you know this guy's doing well. Loves playing video games. That's his little joy. He's into car sex, by the way. Why wouldn't you? If you're in a Ford Ranger, you'd almost be having sex with the car. That's how good that is. He's weighing in today at 90 kilos, playing for the traders. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Francois.
Hello,
hello, good morning, buddy.
Hey, Francois. I got a question, actually, Kyle. So when I've been watching American TVs and they use this car a lot to, like, pick up rich people, you know, so, like, if you're watching Billions, they'd be picking them up in this car. Or Morning Wars, they're picking them up. Same car.
Right.
I think
what
it might
it
be...
look like?
It's a massive car. Like, I think it might be a Bronco. Would that be right?
What year is is this set in? The 80s?
No, it's now.
No. Is it like a big black SUV looking thing?
Massive SUV, and it's got like a little, I think, red emblem of like, I don't know, on the front. And I'm thinking, is this the fancy car in America?
A red emblem on the front?
Let me have a look.
Let me have a look. Oh, is it the Cadillac Escalade?
Oh, how big are they? It might be that.
Well, they're very big. But that's what everyone is getting driven around in on those American shows.
Or it's
the new Lincoln four-wheel drive. I don't know. You give me a photo of it, Jackie. I'll tell you what it is.
And is it, how are they expensive, the Cadillac Escalades?
About 80,000 to 90,000 US. So, not out of the realm of possibility.
Not crazy expensive.
Mm. Why, do you want one?
No, I just was curious.
I could get you one here for 180.
Right.
The steering wheel's on the proper side and everything. Do you want one of those?
Yeah, I kind of don't mind it, to be honest. It is the Cadillac Escalade, you're
is
right.
It? Yeah, well, they're super nice.
Yeah, right.
You really know about cars, don't you, Carl?
Yeah, I know everything about everything.
Yeah,
random things.
Random? That's not random. Well, most blokes know about cars.
Yeah, right. Okay.
Right, Francois? Francois knows.
Three.
He's right. Oh, okay.
All right, let me introduce you to my girl, Mia, from Five Dog. She works
Mia.
As a hairdresser. To work Monday.
Hi.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Very good.
Okay, so she drives a GTI. She's happily single, never been in a relationship.
What?
She's 22, so...
Just
living my best life.
You're just pumping, pumping and dumping?
Yeah.
Pumping and dumping. No relationship?
That's it. That's all you need right now.
Yeah.
I love the sound of this. I wish I was 22 now. When I was 22, you'd have to hold hands, date, meet the parents. Oh,
yeah.
Take 6 months to get a stinky finger.
Once, now it's all online, I think.
Her favourite sex position
on the first date.
Is doggy. Once had sex in a movie cinema, weighs 60 kilos.
Wow, me. Oh, my God.
Whoa.
Wow. Okay, girls.
Sorry, I just got more support today.
Yeah. You know
Friday.
What? You know what? How they almost took us off the air.
Sorry.
You don't understand how distorted and horrific that is.
It literally almost blew my eardrums.
Yeah, you don't understand. I've got headphones on, so's Jackie.
Okay. So
grow up.
Oh, dear. Are you ready, Francois?
You can yell and cheer, but give me the heads up, for God's sake.
Okay, Francois, here's your first question. What's another name for a lash lift?
A what?
A lash lift.
Never heard of that before. Would it be like mascara?
Is it mascara, Jackie?
No. It's actually an eyelash perm. They call it an eyelash perm.
There's no such thing.
Yeah, there is. They use the perming solution to keep your eyelashes up as opposed to going straight out.
No, that's bullshit. You use those little weird scissor torture device looking things on your eyelashes, don't you? Is that the same thing?
Oh, yeah, but that's an eyelash curler, and that's just temporary, you know? That just doesn't last all day. It just lasts a little bit.
You guys really go to the effort of lifting up your eyelashes?
Yeah, because when you put mascara on, then you really, it makes your eyes pop because you're seeing the mascara go up, the eyelashes go up. And that looks really cool.
We've never noticed. We wouldn't even notice if you had no eyelashes.
Yes, you would.
No,
it'd
we
look
wouldn't.
Weird.
I don't think we would. Okay, next question.
Okay, where should you put your crystals out to charge them? When?
In the sun, middle of the day.
In the sun in the middle of the day, is that right?
No, that's incorrect. It is actually when it's a full moon is the perfect time to charge your crystals.
Oh, that's right. I do know that.
Yeah, yeah. Okay,
Nothing worse than getting hooked up with some crystal-loving chick, just so you know. It all becomes, you'll be sticking crystals here, there and everywhere. It's a painful thing.
Yeah, when the blue moon happened,
I don't understand what all that means and what you got to wear and for energy and no thanks.
Yeah.
It's too hard.
Okay, question number three. Prune Dramatic and Pearl Blanche are both types of Chanel what?
Handbags?
Handbags?
Oh, handbags, no. Ugh. It's nail polish.
Oh, do they do Chanel nail polish?
Yes, they do.
What's the difference between normal nail polish and Chanel nail polish?
Oh, it's probably got a better consistency and lasts longer.
I doubt it. I reckon it's just a price.
If you can't have, like, CC on it, what's the point? It just looks like any other, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, black nail polish. You're just
it has the CC. It has the CC on the front.
Does it come out on your? Does it come out on your nails?
Chanel. It says Chanel.
Yeah, but does it come out on your? Yeah, you need.
On your nail? No.
So what's the point?
How does anyone know you got Chanel nail? Why spend $5,000 for a bottle?
It's not like $5,000. It's just that it's, you know, and it's, boy, it's small, you know? Like, it's a small little nail polish.
Oh, so you're getting less than you would at bloody Priceline or whatever.
Yeah, probably.
But they have signature colours too, Kyle.
See, some of the colours.
Do they own a colour?
Yeah, wow. So like that Prune Dramatic is like this really deep purple that's very well known.
Oh, yeah.
Very well known.
Yeah, and like Jackie's right, the consistency's better. It doesn't chip as easy. It's like $50
I get it. These are the justifications you guys say to everyone why you're spending that much money in nail polish. It's ridiculous.
Oh, well, it's true, though. It is true.
You guys are blinded by marketing lies. You get less, sometimes. You pay more, and you're fooled by the consistency is like, come on, girls.
Anyway, moving on to Mia's questions.
Hey, Mia, are you ready for your hard tradie-like questions?
I'm ready to go.
Here we go. I don't know what you like with carpentry. The question number one revolves around that. What is the strongest joint in carpentry? What is the strongest joint?
The corner.
A corner joint is wrong. That's not right. It's the mortise and tenon joint. A lot of carpenters will be like, oh, yeah, we knew that. Jesus knew that too because he was a carpenter.
A lot of carpenters probably don't even know that.
Yeah. You've met carpenters?
I've met a few dating ones, yeah. Oh,
but you're sure not going to be talking about what's the strongest joint?
What
joint
do you use at work?
Well, I'll tell you what the joint looks like. One bit of wood's got a big hole in it, and the other bit of wood's got a knob hanging out of it, and the knob goes in the hole.
Yeah, I've seen that, yeah. Fair enough. Yeah, but I didn't know it was called that.
No.
Yeah.
Question two. Who is the recently appointed coach of the Queensland Origin team?
Coach.
Yeah.
Oh, I wouldn't know.
Just the coach of the Queensland Origin team. It's only a new appointment.
I'm not sure. I can't even tell you any of the players.
Are you not into footy?
No.
No, me neither. I get it. Okay, well, that's...
Do you know if I...
Time's up. Sorry.
Okay. This should make these systems a lot easier.
Yeah, but I think that's the point. Billy Slater is what you're looking for. So you didn't? You know that name, Billy Slater? No.
It rings a bell, maybe.
What would a 22-year-old, single, ready-to-mingle hairdresser give a shit about Billy Slater? I get it. You could win with this one. Listen to this, and listen carefully. What is an A-brace used for? An A-brace. What's that used for?
Is that for an injured part of a body?
What's that?
Wait, no.
No, tell me. I didn't hear you.
No, I don't know if I was right. I don't know if that has anything to do with guys, though.
Is it
like an injured part of a body?
An injured part of a body.
Wait, what did you say? Sorry, say it again.
Okay, I'll read the question out. What is an A-brace used for?
A-brace.
questions are so hard.
Yeah, they're supposed to be.
They're really random.
Yeah, they're not pop quiz questions. They're trading versus lady questions. Just think of it. Think of the letter A. Think of the letter A, right? Picture it in your mind.
A.
Yeah. Picture the letter A. And now think of it as an A brace. What's it used for?
For a corner.
For a corner. You love these corner
she
answers.
She loves to say corner by default.
Wrong. It's not used for a corner. It's a temporary structure that looks like the letter A, made out of bracy stuff.
It
lean it against a wall. It keeps a wall upright and stuff, made out of shit.
Until the framing pieces are installed.
That's right, Jackie. Well done. So none of you got anything right.
That's okay. We go to a tiebreaker. Are you ready?
You ready, guys? You're both back on. Okay.
Just yell out the answer. Whoever gets it right first in will win.
Well, we've lost a lot of energy in this game.
Let's do it. I'm ready.
Okay, get your energy back. Otherwise, you'll never be back on.
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Okay, here we go.
Ready to go.
Okay, what sports brand is known for its three stripes?
Adidas.
Sorry, Mia. You sound like fun, but you lost. It's all about Francois.
Talk shit fighting all night.
Yeah, what's he won, Jackie? Would you like to explain what he won? The smart home bundle by Amazon Alexa.
That's right. And it includes the all-new Echo Show 10 and the Fire TV stick.
That's right. Well done, Francois.
Well done.
Thank you. Bye, Mia.
Bye.
Yeah, everyone's into it. Come on, fellas. What do we do, boys?
We drink, talk shit, fight, sing all night. You're the boys.
There we go. You're the boys indeed. Francois, well done.
Thank you, Francois. Thanks,
Mia.
Thanks, Mia.
I hope we meet up one night somewhere.
Sounds good.
I've been in for the TMI before.
Yeah, right. Oh, have you?
No, I didn't get through.
Not you.
I remember, Mia.
Which one? What did you do?
I remember because of the hairdresser thing. You were fun. She was lots of fun.
Was she? What does that mean?
She was just really honest and, you know, she was bubbly.
Did you meet the guy on the TMI, Mia?
I did, actually. I did meet him.
Did you have sex with him? You had sex with him?
Yeah, I never saw him again. But he's lovely.
You rooted him and then you never saw him again.
Remember, it was a really tall guy. It was a bakery guy.
But you rooted him and then you never spoke to him again.
I kissed him. I rooted him, though.
You don't think you rooted him?
I don't think I did.
You think you did.
Although he does message me sometimes, but yeah, no.
So you did root him?
No, I didn't want to go that far. It was just
hang on, you just you said this is what I you called man. This is what you called smoke and mirrors. You'll hear this from girls a lot.
Yeah.
You're not sure? No, I didn't. But I did. I might have. I don't know. Yeah, I did. No, I didn't.
I didn't want to.
I didn't. I didn't. I've only done it once.
Lovely.
And anyway, why don't you let people come back for a second turn?
I just feel like, you know, you can always tell us the first date. Once you go on the first date and they're just not vibing you, I'm just like, you just get bored.
Right. So you just think, I'll cut
it
off.
It needs to be more entertaining.
But you'll go on a date, have a coffee, give a guy a BJ, and then think, you won't realise before the BJ, no?
Well, because you've given them the BJ, you've already given them that standard already, thinking they're going to get you, if they think they're going to give them another BJ.
Of course. Well, you get one BJ, you think, well, this is how hard can it be to get another one?
And your standards are lowered then, and they're just like, oh, she's just a good
Well, nothing wrong with being labelled that.
I'd die to be labelled that.
Okay, it's diary time. Are you ready?
I am so ready.
I'm more ready, I think, than you are.
Yeah, I disagree.
Well, I've got my sleeves rolled up, everything. I'm ready. Hats off. Ready.
Okay,
just took
it off.
Oh my God, I forgot I had my headphones. I'm going to strangle myself to death.
Here it is, guys. The best bits on and off the air for your week.
Dear Diary, it's been a big week on the Kyle and Jackie O Show. Demi Lovato was on the show. Turns out that Demi and Kyle have something in common.
Demi Lovato, guys. Take it back, bitch. I don't
need introduction. Unidentified with Demi Lovato, which you guys can stream from today.
I'm going straight home from this show and watching it.
Kyle has this obsession with aliens landing one day.
Look, I'm not mental about it. I dared say the other day, if aliens came, would you have sex with the aliens? Yes. I would.
I said I would have to get to know him for a few days first. The question is, would you, Demi?
That wasn't the question, but now you've asked.
I already answered it. I said yes so fast.
God love Demi, always thankful. And Kyle and Jackie O, always grateful.
So good to talk to you guys too. And I do want to say thank you so much because you're doing so great with my pronouns. And don't think I noticed.
I think I made a mistake at the beginning and then I couldn't get over myself. And then I did it again.
But your intention was there and I noticed it. And I just want to say thank you.
Thank you guys.
There's no secrets on this show. The guys tracked down Snappy Tom's Instagram crush and they royally threw him under the bus.
He has been following this guy, Luke, super hard. Luke is unaware of who Snappy Tom is.
Yeah, Tom, let's open the door. Jesus.
Hello. Luke, you're looking away from him as though this is making you slightly uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Sorry that you're the innocent victim in all of this.
Him? What about me?
You're right.
We used to get letters of complaint on this show, but recently we've been getting letters from prison.
I'm getting a nice vibe from these guys.
Wow, this is why she makes so many personal mistakes. I like this whole vibe. It's interesting, right?
It is interesting, and they write, like, interesting stuff. They're not just, you know, boring. They're telling us what's going on in there.
Oh,
it's good.
She's got her flutter on for the bad boy. I can feel it.
Terror.
Off air this week, Jackie got some friendly advice from Kyle about getting laid.
You're a very desirable, beautiful woman.
Yes, you are.
In control of your own life, and you can pretty much do whatever the f*** you wanted.
That's true.
Really?
Boss.
Take all the way your own little inner thoughts. The reality is the reality.
Well, thank you, Mum. That's comforting.
Comforting.
You're not going to get laid, babe. Sorry.
Me?
Yeah.
Hey, I'll f***ing get there. No, I don't care if we're 90.
Jackie is the most competitive person I know. But at least she's honest.
You cheated.
But I was honest about cheating.
That doesn't mean anything.
That counts.
Doesn't it?
Yes, because if I own up to it, that's, you know, to be rewarded, I think.
So if I got a suck from a prostitute and then went home and said, hey, babe, I just got blown by a prozzy, I'm honest, that's not cheating. Just be honest
with me. If you listen to this show for years, you would know that when Kyle's on the edge, someone get a Kit Kat.
Ooh, hang on. Shivering Adam has brought me in a... Are you bringing me Kit Kats because I'm agitated?
Yeah, I thought you might like a Kit Kat.
Sorry, Jackie, I'm just... Am I agitated at Shivering Adam or not?
Dummy. A little to that. That's why I brought you some chocolate.
Thank you. Are you noticing any agitation, Jackie?
I can't stand it.
No more than usual. There we go.
Can you guys continue the show while I gnaw down through these Kit Kats? But we're not quite there yet. Hang on one second. Not a big Kit Kat.
Do you really need that?
Me?
Yeah.
We're going to get in the fat shaming, are we?
God, it's brutal out here.
When the mics are turned off, the fun continues no matter what.
I want to hear Let's Hear It for the Boy, Rita.
Oh, yeah.
Is that a Whitney song?
No.
He don't touch me, but he loves me, loves me, loves me. And nobody now and then he's gay. Let's hear it for the boy.
Call this week. Huh, this girl sure rolled out the fella.
Hello, Jordan.
Hi, guys.
She's going to call her partner, Jai, and tell him that she's submitting her son's birth certificate. She's going to put her last name on the certificate.
His last name means everything to him, but he hasn't proposed to me and I've given him two boys, so I was going.
Hello.
I'm just doing Eden's birth certificate. I'm going to put Eden's surname as my last name.
Come again?
I think I'm going to do Eden with my last name.
So we're going to have two kids and they're going to have different last names.
I've got a solution. We'll give him an extra middle name.
Come again? I've heard some f***ing things in my life, but this is one of the worst.
Only lying.
Off air this week, you can always rely on Kyle.
Kyle is literally the guy you can call at any time, Jackie, and he would be there. I truly believe that. Like,
but I always think of him if anything happens.
For
so
sure, yeah.
He's the one I will call.
Yeah.
No, we're not talking about murder. We're talking about sex.
We took a call from Belinda, and there was quite the fascination, I think.
Oh, hey, guys. How are you?
We are well.
Good.
The weight?
110 kilos.
Jesus Christ.
Good on you, Belinda. How are you?
I don't lie, Kyle. You're a little bit curious about this 110 girl getting on top. I know it.
Bring the beat in.
Maybe it might be as lucky as the blokes that still let me on top.
She's really talking herself up. I'm quite fascinated now.
You feel sorry for big because I'm a big girl and you're a big
no,
boy.
No, I don't feel sorry for big girls.
No, you do. You're like, no, oh, no, I like myself no, because she's a big girl and I'm a big boy.
No. That's not how I think.
I love this girl.
That's not how I think.
On that note, it's been a big week on the Kyle and Jackie O Show. Signed, in Tempe.
Kyle, Jackie O.
Birthdays for Friday, October 8th. Outside cloudy today, 22 in the city, 25 out west. Dozens of people on the phone here that are celebrating a birthday, but we can only choose one, and that one is Tracy in the Hawkesbury.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, Tracy, good morning. How are you?
I'm so excited. I'm good. How are you?
Good, honey.
Good.
How old are you today?
51 today.
51.
Good on you, Trace. 51 years old.
Look at and what her, are you, full of beans, full of energy.
What are you going to do? We're so like close I'm to 40. Freedom Day, but what are you going to do over the weekend?
I have to work, unfortunately, today, but I've planned a Chinese in the park with drinks with my friends.
You've got a Chinese person coming to serve you drinks in the park. What a fabulous birthday.
I wish.
That's a good idea, ordering Chinese.
That's a great
idea. Good one, yeah.
Because you open up all the little things and
it's always cheese and biscuits, which I love, and sandwiches. But, you know, it might be fun to do Chinese food. That's good.
I agree.
Yeah, good idea.
Hey, Lockie's here. Do you want to say happy birthday to Tracy, Lockie?
Happy birthday, Tracy.
Thank you, Lockie. I loved you on the show. I loved you.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed it. All right, let's see if we can get you a cool prize, eh?
Tracy, don't you wish Lockie had buried one away to one of the beauties on Beauty and the Geek?
I did, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, everyone wanted you to get your end in.
No, but well, the beauty...
Is he going to apply for Love Island?
Yeah, well, that was a joke. Sophie did ring him. We did an only lying.
That was an only lying, Trace. Yeah.
But Lockie knew, and Lockie's no idiot. Like, he's fun, but he's not a dill.
Yeah,
he knew.
Exactly.
He knew. You're not going to do well on Love Island. You know that.
No. The guys who are on Love Island, their abs are way too big compared to mine.
Show us your abs. Show us your abs. Lift your shirt. Oh, you're pretty good. If you like 11-year-old boys.
my abs are non-existent.
But you haven't got a gut or anything. Like, what's your chest like? Have you got a muscular chest? You lift your shirt. Oh, God, it inverts. That's quite the amount of hair as well.
Oh, good on you, Lockie.
Oh,
you're a good sport.
So if anyone wants a young man who's lovely and not an idiot, has the body of an 11-year-old boy with an inverted chest and a lot of hair... Lockie's your man.
Lockie. Go, Lockie. All right, shall we spin the wheel, Lockie?
Yeah, let's do it. All right, good luck, Tracy.
Thank you.
Hey, it's always a bit awkward there at the beginning. It's round and round and 23.
I love it. Okay, 23.
What is that?
You won a current body LED mask. It's valued at $490.
Oh, I've seen these things. You put the mask on, it's got lights inside, and it does something to
your face. That's what I'm assuming.
Yeah, I've seen these on TV.
Yeah, you can get better skin with beauty tech leader currentbody.com.au. I need one of those because I see people using them and I think, does that actually make any difference?
Yeah, like the Real Housewives and stuff I've seen on one of those shows, they're wearing these things.
It's like a proper mask, right? Like it's solid, not just, you know,
yeah, like
those
a
foil
jelly
ones.
Yeah.
And the LED stuff, like you can get that from a proper salon as well.
Yeah.
Like they'd actually do that.
So congrats, Tracy. Look at you. You're going to look 30 again when this thing's off.
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much.
Hang on. I've got to do a disclaimer. No guarantee of looking 30. There you go.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Got a couple of songs
I'm
for you.
I'm very happy.
Jackie and I are stuck with this Jax Jones song.
Which is it's a good song. It's just Brooklyn's going harder every day, you know, to beat us.
Desperate to stand out from the crowd.
No, not desperate, you know.
We've got this. You don't know me, Jax Jones. No, thanks for asking. It's a fun song. You like that, right, Tracy?
I do like that.
Yeah, that's a good song.
Trace, all right, what are you pulling out?
Sexy thing. I've got this song. We all love it. It's Sigma, Nobody to Love.
Oh, I love that as well. Song. Oh, no.
Our last day in lockdown, our last show.
You're right. I think he's beaten us, Jackie. I think so.
Yes. I'm gonna have to go to Brooklyn.
Yeah, I get it.
Sorry, guys.
That's all right. Listen,
it's a good song.
It is.
I love it.
It'll put me in the mood.
In the mood for what?
Just for a good day.
For Chinese.
For work.
For Chinese, for that Chinese man tomorrow.
I can't wait.
Happy birthday, Tracy. Have a good one. Hey, guys, Pop Quiz is on the air soon.
Thank you.
Don't go away. We've got the credit card coming out as well, everyone. And someone will decide who's mental, me or Jackie. It'll be official. Sigma this morning. Here at Kiss FM, you're on the air. Kyle and Jackie O. Morning, everyone. Hello. Cloudy today, 22 in the city, 25 degrees out west. And thanks to the Sangria Spring Special at Dan Murphy's BWS, Jackie's got some own news for us.
Well, Daniel Craig is still doing the rounds promoting his very last Bond movie, and he was on Jimmy Kimmel's show, and Jimmy Kimmel wanted to know, like, how would you feel if the next Bond was an American? Because that would make it the first American.
Oh, really?
To ever play Bond. Oh, yeah.
They're all English usually, aren't they? The English.
Usually. Or what was Sean Connery? Was he Scottish?
Oh, same area.
Right.
To me, that's all England.
And then the Australian one that you know, Carl.
That's right. George Lazenby.
The one no one has ever... I wouldn't be able to describe that guy if you paid me.
Anyway, so have a listen to Daniel Craig's response.
Do you get to choose? Do you get any say in who the next Bond is?
No.
None at all?
Not my problem, no.
Would you have a problem with an American being the next James Bond?
No, why? Why would I have a problem with an American being?
I can't imagine.
I feel like you've got a put of issue here that I think needs to be sorted out.
Me, personally?
Yeah, I do. But you need to know something.
Yeah.
Because it's already happened.
What?
I'm a U.S. citizen.
Oh, okay.
So it's already happened.
Oh, great. So
I don't know. Yeah, that's a line there. He's British, but he's a U.S. citizen. I don't think that matters. I think they want an American to be it.
Yeah, and also, he's just trying to, like, take away the limelight for the next guy if he is American. Because now they can't say first American. You know what I mean?
Is it not going to be a woman, is it?
No, I don't
think. Are you sure?
Yeah.
No, I'm all for women in film. But you can't change James Bond into a woman because the woke people are trying to do that.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to happen, Kyle, but he revealed like what it was like on the first day of the first film and how he had to do the line, the famous line of Bond, James Bond. Oh. And he wanted to know, Jimmy Kimmel, whether Daniel Craig was nervous about delivering such an iconic line.
When you're on set and you, the first time you say Bond, James Bond, does everybody get really excited?
I mean, I feel like the weight of it is always so great on it. And
yeah,
the first time I say it in Casino Royale, I mean, I couldn't say it. I mean, I was like, sorry, I got this. Suddenly the whole kind of like, you know,
yeah,
like 20 movies or however many there were, is the weight is there. And it comes out eventually. And Piers had the same deal. He talks about it. And he used to practice in the mirror over and over again. And I used to practice in the mirror and think, like this. I couldn't believe I was James Bond.
Practicing in the mirror?
Yeah, of course. I knew it. No. I knew actors would practice in front of the mirror. But every time ask them, do you practice in front of the mirror, they say no.
Yeah, because it sounds lame.
I know. But, you know, it's the best way to do it. Like, practice something like that
practicing
in front of the
mirror.
Practicing
in the mirror, saying Bond, James Bond. How
yeah, because you want to look at what your face looks like when you say it. You know, you want to look, you want to make sure you look
sexy. You
know
what your own face looks like.
Tough, cool, all these things that James Bond is, you know?
That's a bit disappointing to hear that. I can understand Pierce doing it because, like, he's not a great actor. So, but I'm surprised Daniel Craig has to practice in the mirror.
Well, he did. There you go.
Now, he never really liked being James Bond. I get that vibe.
I think he liked it first time and then got sick of it really quickly. Yeah. Probably because it's, like, I would say quite a lot of work and taxing, you know.
Yeah, you're right.
A bit of running around and probably
The poor thing, all that money and being a big movie star must be exhausting.
Courtney Stodden, you know, the one that got bullied by Chrissy Teigen and really was responsible for the demise of Chrissy.
Oh, is that, like, was she that young girl, blonde, big-titted thing, got married to an old 50-year-old sort of dude?
Yeah, like,
yes,
she
I remember her.
She's talked further about exactly how, you know, involved Chrissy was in bullying her online. And apparently it went on for years. And you got to wonder, like, what's up with Chrissy Teigen doing this to a teenager? What did she have against her that made her just taunt her all the time? She explains, Courtney Stodden. Here it is.
She was obsessed with me. She would DM me almost at least like 3 times a week publicly, but then she would privately DM me at night. Like, it would always be like at night. I don't know if it was John was sleeping. I don't know what the heck was going on, but she would DM me and, you know, tell me I'm ugly and like just really like things that would you would tell someone that you want to make feel bad. And I was 16, 17, 18 and 19 years old. So this went on for years. I mean, this wasn't just, you know, a week obsession of trolling. This was years stalking me, telling me to die. I never even met her. I never spoke to her. And for some reason, she just wanted me dead. And to this day, she's ignoring it.
How
That's
weird.
Very unsettling. There's something not quite right if you're doing that for 4 years solid.
Like, she didn't
even know her.
Never met her. It's a stranger.
How can you hate someone for that long and you don't even know them, and then just constantly badger them? I don't get it. Anyway.
No, it could be mental health issues there. It sounds
Probably.
It doesn't sound normal.
No, anyway. Good news for our Australian actor Ryan Corr, who we love. He's been cast in the Game of Thrones prequel spin-off House of the Dragon.
Oh my lord, what a great gig for him.
So his character is Sir Harwin Breakbones Strong. And it will
focus. Is that supposed to mean something? Just a terrifying name?
Just sounds like break bones. Sounds terrifying.
Sounds like a gangster of some description.
And obviously, this happens 200 years before Game of Thrones. So, yeah.
So, no iPhones or any of that. You won't
well,
see
there
any
were
of that.
No iPhones, but you won't see any Starbucks coffee cups on the table time. Okay, let's do pop quiz, guys. If you want to try and win a 10 grand for your Friday, we will open the lines now on 13 1065.
$10,000 pop quiz.
Pop quiz. Let's go to the phones, Jackie. Melissa is on from Yaguna, wants to play for 10 grand. Melissa, hello.
Hi, Melissa.
Hi. Oh my god.
Good morning.
I've been trying for like 10 years to get through.
Are you kidding?
Oh my god, and this is the first time you've been on?
10 years.
First time I've been on. Okay. I've been a listener from the very start. Oh my goodness.
Melissa, relax. A lot of people say when they play along at home, they breeze through it. Boom, boom, boom. And when they get on, they're like, oh, it's a whole different vibe, and they're like, the pressure's real.
Yeah, it can be.
Yeah, I get like 3 or 4 right, and I'm listening to you guys, so probably like 1 today.
Wow.
You know, we'll see how I go. I'm not very good.
You never know. You could just blitz it.
You've got to be in it to win it. You never know your luck. Jackie's right.
Okay, take
a breath. Here are the rules. 60 seconds on the clock. Every question you get right, you get $100. If you get all 10 right, which even you admit would be a stretch, you'll win $10,000.
Wow.
Good luck, Melissa.
Okay.
Here we go. Good luck.
Question number one. Kristen Bell played what character in the TV show Veronica Mars?
Pass.
Joe Bros is the abbreviated name for which pop band?
The Jonas Brothers.
Yes.
Which Kardashian is hosting SNL this weekend?
Kim.
Yes.
Which pop star just announced the dates for her Happier Than Ever Aussie tour?
Pass.
Name the Rabbitohs player that recently announced his retirement.
Oh, I should know this, but no, pass.
Who is Kylie Minogue's boyfriend?
Carl Edmonton passed.
Well, no one knows that guy's name. He's not even
name
a name.
The British, name the British music group that released a remix of Whitney Houston's How Will I Know.
Not
past. Okay, which royal family member is rumoured to be releasing her own line of cosmetics?
Not past.
Squid Game star Yung Ho Yen has just become an ambassador for which luxury brand?
Oh, no past. I'm looking
pick a brand. Just pick a brand.
Pick a brand.
A luxury brand. Louis Vuitton.
Correct.
Yes. And model Marlo Stevens is dating which Aussie singer?
Oh, sorry,
time's
doesn't
up.
Doesn't matter. Tried to get it in.
I got some right.
You got 300. You got three right, Melissa. You did okay.
Just as predicted.
That's my average.
Yeah, that's it.
You can't ask for better than that. Okay, Kristen Bell played what? Veronica Mars in the Veronica Mars show. Billie Eilish is the artist coming out for the Happier Than Ever tour. Benji Marshall, the Rabbitohs player, recently retired. Paul Solomonos, or whatever his name is.
Solomons, yep. That's Kylie's
that's
boyfriend.
That's Kylie's boyfriend. Clean Bandits doing the remix of the Whitney song. Meghan Markle. Oh, you can't say which royal.
I thought that as well.
You can't claim Meghan Markle as a member of the royal family. She hates the royal family.
Exactly.
She's that's like a cancer word. Within the royal family, eating away at the establishment.
Eat away.
What? That's what I think. Eating away like a rat gnawing through cheese. We'll have to give her that. We'll have to give you that because we really...
Thank you.
The question was wrong.
Yeah.
So you got $400. Well done.
There you go.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Dale. Wow, happy Friday to you. Enjoy yourself.
Thanks, Melissa.
Bye, Dale. Nice to meet you. Prisoner Pen Pals. Jackie, you have more letters, right?
Yeah, I haven't read this one yet. Let me quickly read
Don't
it.
Don't even quickly read it. Just read it out on air. So we'll
okay.
read it all
I'll
to
I'll
we'll
read
all
it all out
it
on
same.
Air. Okay, yeah.
Plus, we're getting the KISS credit card out, and we did a psychological test. I don't know why, but Mayo put us onto it.
Yeah.
She asked all these questions. Our answers have been given to some doctor, some quack, who's going to come in and decide... whether Jackie or myself are even close to being mentally stable.
Hmm.
You got any clues there, Mayo, as to how the results are going to work out?
I was surprised by a few of the points, but yours was pretty spot on. I feel like Jackie I was more surprised about.
Oh, so why?
Jackie's mental.
No.
Oh, I can't wait for this bloke now.
No.
I could be actually wrong. She could think she's mental and you are not.
Yeah, the surprising thing is Jackie's fine.
Yeah.
Wait, why? So you all think I'm mental?
Oh, 100%.
Why?
I don't think you're mental. But there's mental behaviour.
Just
there.
weird behaviour.
What do you call them? Eccentricities? You've got a really
yes,
cute name
eccentric,
for it.
Eccentric, quirky. Yeah.
A lot of the rest of us say nut job, but...
not a nut job. I'm not a nut job to be with. I'm really
not. No. Well, even just to know you're not a nut job.
Yeah.
No.
I mean, you guys know. Everyone listening on air, they all know.
No. Which one? That you are or you aren't?
They know that I'm a bit of a, you know... Cuckoo, but yeah.
Loosey-goosey. Well, she might have a peanut in her and be in the bath with women, but she's not crazy.
You're not allowed to say that story. That story's
been
banned.
I didn't say the whole story. I just said the end.
Okay.
If you're ever wondering what's the end of that story, well, peanut in the mud.
Yeah, but it was...
There's more to it, actually.
There needs to be context. That makes me sound gross.
No, that
I didn't know what I was doing. I was young.
Now we're going into the territory that we... We're going to get the credit card out soon. You can charge your bills to KISS, Morrow News, and the psychologist coming on to assess mine and Jackie's brain capacity.
Well, just, yeah, everything, like how we function, how mentally stable we are.
I'm worried about it.
Oh,
you got a new love letter from the prisoners?
I do. I have our last one, and then we will decide which we should choose to be our regular pen pal prison.
Can I just put this back on you? There's no we. This is your thing.
Okay.
I'm not writing letters. Like I don't mind the guys, but I'm not committing to being having a pen pal.
Yeah, but you'll like hearing the letters.
I will love hearing the letters. Yeah.
You like that part.
But I don't want it to be me, like, oh, it's your turn to... I'm not getting into that.
Don't worry. Leave that too.
Because this is... you and the girls, you thought this was fascinating.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't believe that women could fall in love with someone in prison. Now look at you guys. You're frothing every time a bloody male shows up.
I know, because I always want to see what they say. It's interesting to hear about why they're in there and... you know, like what they do in there, and is it okay? Is it violent? Is it, what is it? All of those things.
You're fascinated.
I'm fascinated, yeah.
Who's with you? You, Mayo's fascinated, Palace, all the girls are into it.
Are the guys into it?
You gays into it?
No.
What?
You're not into it? I don't give a shit either, really. Like, I like hearing the letter, but...
And Pedro's so into it, he messages me every time you read them out, Jax.
So Pedro's like a woman?
Yeah.
I don't mind hearing it, but, like, the girls all running around, oh, we got a letter from Mo. Oh, come on.
No one writes letters anymore, so it's kind of cute.
I know. It's fun to wait for your letter to arrive.
No, it's not.
It is for me, okay?
Wait for your letter to arrive. Okay, let's get the Aiko song on, then we'll read the current letter out. You're at Kiss FM. Happy Friday. Good morning, everyone. Pen pal. Now, pen pals, Jackie's been writing them. She loves waiting by the mailbox like it's 1940, waiting for the post to arrive and wonder, will the love of her life have written her a letter?
It's not about the love of my life, Kyle. It's more of just an insight into prisoners. So don't forget, we heard earlier, we have to choose today which one we're going to write to continuously.
We've had a few, right? There's been a...
Well, we had Mo first from Blacktown.
2148.
Yeah, he That's was painting him. Prison to kind of be not that bad, you know?
Like, what was he in for?
Actual bodily harm, robbery, and drug-related charges.
Hot blood.
And then we had Tara.
Yeah, that's right.
Tara, who's in jail for 7 years. And he wrote a pretty good letter because he talked about life inside prison, but also said he was going to give us tips each week on, you know, what to do in prison. So
his first tip was about not smelling out the cell. No number twos in the cell unless that's it's right. an emergency.
Yeah, then we had NJ, who called us while he was in prison, got into a lot of trouble, and and then we heard from him, you know. And,
exactly.
Yeah. So today, Aaron has written to us from his prison cell, and sounds like he's in there for insider trading.
Oh.
Okay, so...
I've never understood why insider trading is illegal. That's clever business. If some bloke says, hey, guess what? The Telstra shares are going to surge... That's just passing on info. I've never believed in the insider trading. That's bullshit.
Yeah.
I don't like that. That whole, like, some idiot made that law up that's a loser that can't figure out business.
Yeah.
I guess because your regular person is buying shares.
Who cares?
And they should be treated fairly, you know?
Oh, all this fair bullshit. The world doesn't work fairly.
Okay, well, let's read the letter that Aaron has written to us.
Okay.
Hey, guys, good to connect. Prison can be a bit lonely at times in here, and unless you smuggled in a phone or someone you know has smuggled in a phone, I haven't, it gets pretty boring in here.
Yeah, right.
Writing letters and using the jail phones are the only way I can communicate. My family and friends have all disowned me, and I don't get any visitors.
Oh, what? Really?
Oh, my God.
From insider trading.
For insider trading.
That's crazy.
Wow. The only person that replies back to me is my old neighbor, who is 56 and not very well. So who knows how long he'll be around for me to talk to. I feel for this guy so much.
See
okay.
how easy Jackie falls under the spell of a well-crafted letter?
Why do you think the family doesn't talk to him?
Well, I don't know.
Surely there's more to it than we know.
They're probably embarrassed because they're probably from a high society family and they probably, oh, the shame he's brought, you know, your kid's in prison. Drop your ego. Look after your child.
Exactly. Okay, so he goes on to say, why am I in here? Well, without going into too much detail, let's just say it involved me getting some inside info ahead of time. That made a shit ton of money, but I didn't get away with it. Got busted.
Oh, spew.
Now I'm in here for the next year, but with COVID, everything is slower, so it could be a bit longer. Hopefully, I'll be eligible for parole and good behavior in July next year.
So we did a little bit of business fraud or whatever, this insider trading. It's not a big deal, I think.
Mm.
And he's in jail for a year.
Yeah.
A year.
Yes.
I reckon that's ridiculous.
That's about
harsh.
The time you get, yeah.
Then you see kids get like people get busted with a couple of bags, you know, and they're they don't go to jail. They got drugs, you know. I just don't believe. Not that I believe you should go to jail for drugs either. I think that's ridiculous. But insider trading, come on. a year in prison. We're paying for that guy to exist as well. Taxpayers paying for all that.
He goes on to write, "It is true in here. Everyone is a big fan of you guys. I heard when the grill team was on Triple M, there could be a few fights over what show to listen to in the morning because a few of the boys in here love footy."
I get that.
"But now that that shit-ass Moon Man is on Triple M, no one fights over the radio anymore. It stays on Kyle and Jackie O every morning." Oh,
wow. Well, that's good. What an honour.
What an honour, exactly.
Unless your name's Moon Man, then you'd feel like pretty bad.
Not even the prisoners want to listen to you. "Still getting adjusted to a few things in here. You might struggle, Kyle."
Why? Am I going to prison?
If you went to prison, I think.
Why?
"They definitely don't have the top-tier Foxtel package in here. I reckon
that would kill me.
I reckon you'd live a good life in here, though, because you have some money.
Right.
So if you pay the right people, you quickly find yourself at the top of the food chain. But if your money runs out, then you'll quickly be known as a dog. And all I can say is good luck."
Money never runs out. Plus, but
I think you get a certain amount. You've got a cap amount. I don't think
Jackie, that's for the buy-up for Tim Tams. They're talking about, like, if I needed protection in jail, I don't pay the prisoners. I pay their family outside of jail. So I look after, I've got a lot of friends in prison all over the country.
I get it. And that's why he says if the money runs out and you're no longer looking after family, good luck with that.
Yeah. But anyway, that's
you'd
fine.
You'd be fine then.
You'd be fine.
Yeah, you've got an endless supply.
I don't want to be in there, though, with the standard Foxtel package and... I don't like the sound of it.
I don't think there is Foxtel, is there?
I feel that in some jails you can get Foxtel. I don't know why.
Maybe
I feel
just
that.
Sport or something, you know?
I don't know.
I don't think they're getting the whole movie package.
You want like Netflix and Disney Plus. That's what you want these days.
You can't just be stuck with one platform, you know?
No.
Okay. "Still getting adjusted to a few..." Oh, no, I've read that. "You guys should do a radio show from the prison one day."
We've tried that.
We did try that. "You can interview us and we'd love to see Jackie in person."
Sounds ominous.
"Love to keep this going from a massive fan of the show, Aaron."
He sounds like a top bloke.
Yeah, he sounds good too. I'm now struggling
Someone's got some info on the Foxtel. What's the info there?
Yeah, Jared Hayne requested to get Foxtel when he went to jail and it was denied. So I don't think Foxtel's a thing in jail.
But if he requested it, it must be someone must be able to get it.
Well, we've just Googled it. Apparently no inmates get Foxtel at all.
But if I was top dog, would I get it?
I don't think so. I mean, I reckon Jared Hayne would be pretty top dog. And he would have his own cell.
I don't think he is top dog, I don't think it's going that well.
Yeah.
Like, I think, I don't know, I haven't heard, but yeah. Not everyone likes everyone, you know. Jackie, I reckon you'd survive in prison too. You'd have to do a lot of vagina licking, but I think you'd get through it.
Yeah. Anyway, don't like to talk about that.
You keep that vagina on the down low.
No. Okay, so that's what we've got to choose from.
Okay, there.
Now, does anybody want to vote on who they think? Because I think I know in my mind who I think would make...
Yeah, I've got one.
You both? I don't have anyone in mind that stands out. They all seem like fun fellas.
They're all great and they've all written excellent letters and, yeah, it's very difficult to choose. But in my mind, I think Tara is going to give us a lot of information over the coming months because
Tara's the guy who... the only tip he's given us is... every time you drop a turd out, you flush it so it doesn't stink up the cell.
No, he gave us a lot of information about being in jail. It was quite an interesting letter, like very informative, I thought.
Have you been reading that letter of his over and over?
No.
He's rolling around on the couch. Oh, Tara.
Tara, I don't even know. I know, I haven't. What does anyone have any, like, preferences?
Anyone?
Well, Brooklyn,
I liked
you do.
Tara as well. I really liked NJ just because he went that extra mile and called us.
I like NJ.
I think NJ's like our mate.
I think he gets out in March. It'd be cool to meet him. But I agree with you, Jackie. Tara gives a bit more.
He gives a lot
in his
letters.
She likes the name. Jackie's into names. She likes the word Tara.
Well, I just felt like he had a lot more that he could tell us, but he was going to wait until the next
one. Right.
I don't know. That's just the vibe I got from his letter.
I don't have a preference. I've got to be honest. But I'm not writing any of these letters. I might yell out from the background every now and then. What's up?
Yeah, you girls pick it because you're the ones that are you're so the frothers. Into it.
Yeah, like, so what
Why
do you think?
Why don't we write both of them back, Jax?
Yeah.
You're going to play these guys off against each other?
Yes.
I think that's a good idea. We'll do. We'll narrow it down to Tara and NJ.
I think you should be honest and you should tell them both about each other. Like, you're not the only one I'm writing to. I'm writing to this guy as well. See what happens.
That may not go well.
I don't want to do that.
Might be a jail yard fight over these girls.
We don't even know if they're in. I don't think they're in the same prison, any of these guys.
Oh, well,
you're
fine then.
They're not in the same prison.
You guys have mapped this. There's something sick about you two. With your whole, you've covered all the prisons.
Yeah, I have. Jackie and I did a deep dive. We wanted like a legit, a good pen pal, you know?
Oh, hang on. We got this bloke from the Central Coast who's just got out of the clink.
Oh, okay, cool.
Hey, Chris. Good morning. You're on the air. How are you, buddy?
Yeah, good, thanks. Good. Thanks for putting me on.
You're welcome. So you just got out? You're just out of lockup?
Yeah, I just got out 2 weeks ago. I got bail, strict bail conditions.
And how long were you in there for?
I got bail. I was in there for just on 4 months, but that's really just a process, you know. You've got to get your brief and all that sort of carry on to see how serious your charges are.
Oh, good God. And
I got caught up on the Anim stuff, so a lot of people.
Oh, you're on that bloody app.
Yeah, got butchered. Yeah.
There's quite a few people got caught up in that whole web.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, now the AFP, they're just going to beep everyone. It's just, they got so much. It's crazy time. But what do you do?
But like, in all honesty, you know that Anon app, Jack. You know what happened there? Like, that
no,
was,
not really. I know.
Made
I heard about
by
it.
The police.
Yeah.
And then passed around everyone. And unfortunately, it's hard to fact check. Like, if someone that you sort of respect in that world says, "Oh, this is a secure thing. No one can find it," you believe them. It was a real. It was a real like.
And was it drug dealing or something?
Oh, who knows? All those sort of.
Everything. Yeah, I was just collateral damage myself. But once the AFP got a hold of you, there's no letting go. There's no letting go. Asset seizure. They take everything. Everything.
Yeah. If you, they even say, look, if you've got a nice BMW
won't even
or something.
$2 in the bank.
Yeah. If you've got a BMW or something, they go, "Oh, how did you earn the money for that? Show me exactly how you earned the money. If you can't provide every pay slip, every detail, every bank account, then they just take it. They go,
right.
Kyle.
Yeah.
Even if you can pay for everything, they've got backup laws to cover stuff. So if you're caught in a crime, if you're caught with drugs or money in your car, the car becomes part of the crime and they've got another way of taking all your stuff anyhow.
Yeah,
so,
and I think even if they pull someone over, and I might be wrong here, this is just stuff I've heard. If you get pulled over and you've got more than $2,000 cash on you, and let's face it, I've got about 10 grand every day on me, sometimes more, then they just assume, oh, that's too much, you're up to something. That's mental.
Mm.
Plenty of people are rolling around with plenty of folding, heaps of them.
Mm.
Yeah. Hey, with the TVs.
Yeah.
Oh, there's no Foxtel, that's for sure.
Oh.
But people are even lucky to even get a TV.
So what are you going to watch? Just free to air?
No, you got free to air. They got all the Seven Mate and all that sort of stuff, which is a bit of a bonus. But
the digital channel. You don't have Stan or any of those things, you know.
Nah. Well, when you go into jail now through intake, you do 2 weeks in quarantine.
Yeah.
You'd be lucky to even get a TV. They stick you in a dog box and just feed you through a hole.
Oh my God.
No, it's pretty ordinary. But there's a lot of people in there. One thing I noticed when I was in there is so many people in there for AVOs.
Is that right? The apprehended violence orders?
Oh, all that stuff.
And this is like relationships.
Getting done about relationships. There's blokes getting butchered left, right, and center. My Sally was in there for 4.5 months, and he was a security guard for 32 years. It wouldn't hurt a soul, and he just got caned. But anyhow.
Like, I know these laws are there. That mainly, the laws are put into place to protect people, but more often than not, the people get caught up on the wrong side of this by mistake, and they're just assumed guilty.
Well, the media's got a hold of it, so they're obligated to push it more. So the judges are slamming down on all the domestic stuff. So
I came from a domestic situation when I was younger, so you think, oh, those laws are for a good reason, so women don't get bashed by drunken, crazy husbands. But I even know my own brother once got arrested on a domestic violence charge, and he never touched the woman. And then the girl eventually said, "Oh, I lied, and I was angry. He was watching Bathurst and not paying attention." And then she got arrested for making a false police complaint.
Yeah,
and like so, these things happen. Like people are crazy.
Yeah, but she says she was in a bad place at the time, and
yeah, and then she gets out of it.
Sorry for them, and they're out of it.
And that happens to men and women. Like it's not just men, not just women.
Right.
But the laws are there for a main reason, but it can sometimes work against you, I suppose.
Chris, thanks for your call. I appreciate it.
Yeah, if the RSPCA went into jails, they closed them down.
Yeah, it's worse than a dog pound, right?
They're worse.
It's not like Wentworth. Is it like Wentworth? That TV show Wentworth?
No. You got to get in a working. If you can get yourself in a working pod, where you can actually get a bit of freedom and extra food and that, but.
Is there a relaxation pod and a spa pod? That's where I'd be. But there is no. So, hey, we're getting the credit card out next, guys.
Well, hang on. Who are we picking? Are we going to just do Tara and NJ and then go from there, are we?
Oh, that's right. You're trying to pick your favourite.
Yeah, yeah. I reckon you're right, Palestine.
Yeah, let's write them both, Jax.
Okay, we'll do that.
Play them off against each other.
See what their second letter entails.
Yeah.
And then we'll decide.
Yeah.
Okay. Good idea. Credit card out. We're charging it to KISS next.
Give the bills a miss and charge it to KISS.
Yeah, we got the credit card out. All thanks to Celebrity MasterChef. That starts on Channel 10 Sunday night, 7:30. All the celebrities there. You'll know all the faces. They're all cooking. A few familiar faces on there.
Yeah, like Rebecca Gibney.
Yeah,
Ian
she looks Thorpe. Good. Rebecca Gibney looks like she's gone into a time machine.
I know, she looks so great. Who else is on there? Dami M? I'm sure I saw Dami M.
I don't know. Did you see anyone else on there? Anyone else got any...
Yeah, Dami's on it as well.
Yeah, we just said that.
Tilly Ramsey, Gordon Ramsey's daughter.
Isn't Ian Thorpe on?
Yeah, we said that.
Oh, my God, no one's listening to us, Kyle.
Jackie, I listen to every word you say. Don't worry about those kids.
Far out.
They're too busy tuning their pictures to make themselves look better on Instagram, not paying attention to the real world.
Oh, dear. Okay. Well, let's charge it to KISS, shall we, guys?
Let's do it.
We got Dom. Hey, Dom.
Good morning.
You're kidding. How
Dom,
good?
You're the chosen one, my friend. We're getting the credit card machine out right now.
How good is that?
Okay,
how
I got the card. I'm great. How you doing?
Yeah, a bit nervous, eh?
It's all right.
Well, you don't know how much is on the credit card. You can keep pushing it with all three bills and hope it gets accepted, but the minute it gets declined, everything is cancelled.
That's right.
No money for you.
Okay. Now, I'd go, depending on what size these bills are, like, don't leave the biggest one till last because then you'll chicken out like everyone else does.
Yeah, I'm going big or I'm going home. So
okay.
Stop.
Okay.
What's the first swipe you want us to make?
Well... As soon as COVID ends, I got my 21st coming up, so I think I'm just going to go $1,000 for a big night out with a friend.
Oh, so this is not a current bill. This is a on the
this is
on
a pre-planned
the...
future bill.
I love this guy.
This is a future bill.
Okay, so $1,000 for a big night out. Type in $1,000.
Approved.
Easy. That's easy.
The boys.
Done. Yeah, the boys
are
indeed.
Easy. How good is that? Yeah. Let's go.
Okay, now you're excited, Dom.
You got any other actual bills you want to try and slide through here?
No, I'm done. I'm going to take it home now.
Oh, what?
I'm all good. Yeah, no, I'm done. I'm happy.
Okay, well, that's your choice.
Decided.
Your
choice.
I'm a very happy man.
You got $1,000. What were the other two bills, by the way?
I was going to say about $500 for my university fees.
Okay, well, that would have been approved, just saying, but you missed out. Is there another one?
Yeah, I was going to go up and see my grandma up at the Gold Coast, so I was going to go an extra $300.
Oh, well, that would have been approved. What happened to go approved. Big or go home? What happened there?
I did. I thought the 1,000 was going to be huge.
Going big is all three. Go big, go home. Hey, doesn't matter. He didn't want to risk it. He's got the $1,000. Have the time of your life, Dom.
No.
Happy 21st for when that comes up as well.
Thanks so much, Dom.
Bye, man. See you, buddy. He's a happy man. He doesn't care. He's fine.
He's just got a big night out with the boys. That's what he cares about, Kyle.
Well, how big is $1,000? I'm telling you.
These days, it's expensive. If you're paying for everyone, I mean, cocktails are expensive.
Oh, he's probably just going to a pub and putting it on the bar.
Oh, yeah, that'd
I was
get
thinking
you
he'd
far.
Get a Meriton joint, you know, get all the fellas around, start going through the apps.
Yeah, that's a lot. That's a bit more. That's a wee bit more.
You need at least 8 to 10 grand for that sort of a weekend.
Wow, okay. Okay. We got a round of our news, guys, coming up next. Stand by.
That doesn't even include the whore money.
Here's Jackie's own news.
All right. Willow Smith, the daughter of Will Smith and Jada Pinkett Smith, has talked about the time she got stalked.
How old is she now? Because I remember when that song came out, she was only like a teenager, right?
Yeah, this would have been when she was young too, actually.
Right.
Because it happened a while back. But this guy... He's a pedophile, and he was cyber-stalking her and then broke into her house. And she tells the story. Have a listen.
Cyber-stalking turned into real life. Cyber-stalking is a little bit more insidious and scary because it's like checking the geotags on your photos. And they're like, where do they go for their Christmas vacations? Where do they go with their family when they're over here? They're watching all of your social media accounts to see what your movements are. And this guy was doing that to me. And he was doing that to me for a couple years, actually. And he basically got my patterns during December when we were gone for family vacation.
Right.
He actually came to my house and broke in while we were away.
Yeah. Waiting for you to come home.
Thank God I wasn't there. That was a physical trespassing situation.
And he had priors. Mm-hmm. His priors were scary.
He was a pedophile. So I ended up having to go to court and testify about it.
Well, the good thing is he is in custody.
Terrifying.
Terrifying. And then Willow's mum, Jada, talked about the precautions they then had to take when they returned home.
Yeah.
And it's sort of like you wouldn't think about this, but it's interesting what they had to do. Have a listen.
We had to take all the stuff out the refrigerator because we were afraid maybe he put something in the drinks or in her food to knock her out. Or, you know, like we had to go through everything, toothpaste, everything. Everything in the house had to go.
Now, see, I wouldn't have thought about toothpaste.
Oh, yeah, no, we did. We went in events. We did all, like, because we didn't know if he put cameras up. Mm-hmm. Like,
right.
We had to, like, really, like, strip the whole house down.
Jesus.
Yeah, you don't think about that, do you?
But I do.
I would never have thought, well, maybe I would have if it actually happened to me.
Yeah, I think if it happens and you start thinking, well, what were they doing? Didn't steal anything. What were they doing?
Yeah, true. And I can confirm who will not be the new James Bond. That is Idris
Elba. That must be a
Elba.
Very long list.
No, but only because Idris Elba has been talked about so much when it comes to being the new Bond.
They've said no, it's definitely not him.
He said that. He said he is definitely not going to be James Bond.
Oh, he wanted to be, didn't he?
I think he did.
We had him on a while back and he said that, oh, God, that'd be the role of a lifetime.
Yeah, but, you know, not happening. So I can only assume maybe whoever makes the decisions in Bond land, they don't maybe want him.
Well, and obviously we like him, so he's one of the first. But who knows? They always pick right, I think, on this James Bond.
They do. They're pretty good at picking. And we now know whether Carol Baskin will be in Tiger King 2 or not, because in Tiger King, Carol was shocked at how she was portrayed and the storyline Netflix went through.
Was she?
Yeah, because it really made it look like she killed her husband.
Oh, that's what everyone thinks.
Yeah, and you can understand because, like, the whole of TikTok was dancing to a song where it was pretty much saying she killed her husband. You remember that song?
Yeah, this one.
Carol Baskin killed her husband, whacked him. Can't convince me that it didn't happen. Fed him to tigers, they snacking. What's happening?
Yeah, this was big, wasn't it? I remember this.
I loved that so much, that song. Anyway, during an interview with Behind the Velvet Rope, Carol Baskin opened up about whether she's keen to do a season 2.
They just recently, like in the last couple of months, reached out and said, you know, we'd like to clear the air. And it's like, no. I told them to lose my number. Most of the other people, they went back to them and got them to sign contracts, different contracts this time. And what they had them sign in the contracts this time was that they could not talk to anybody but them. And I think what they were trying to do is they realized, this is just my belief, that this was such a successful runaway hit. They didn't want anybody actually talking to these people to get to the truth. They wanted to maintain the narrative that they have already put out there. And so we just refused to even talk to them.
I'm sus on it still.
Mm.
And you know what? I could care less about another Tiger King. I'm done with that. I've moved on.
I didn't even watch it, to be honest.
You never watched any of that?
Mm-mm. No, it didn't interest me
at all. You were talking about it nonstop.
Only because I knew people loved it. So, you know, I'm happy to reflect what people love, but I didn't watch it personally. I wasn't into it.
I've moved on. Even if that Netflix brought something else out about it, I don't think I'd be into it. I feel like I know the whole story.
Nothing. You know? I mean, I know he's in prison. Maybe there's that. But apart from that, and if you don't have Carol Baskin on there, then, yeah. You need her on there, I think. I haven't even watched this show, so I don't know if you need her. Do you need her?
I don't know. You need the Tiger King guy. He's the main guy.
Right. Okay. Okay. Fair enough. Now, coming up next, Kyle and I have done a very long psychology assessment, and we will get the results next as to what we're all about. God, that's scary, isn't it?
Not really. Are you worried about it? I could care less.
Oh, no. Yeah. No.
You're worried about what people might think of what they hear?
Well, no, not really. Maybe. Who knows what he's going to say? Not really, if I'm honest.
Well, it doesn't sound like
he's looking at me and he's assessing me as I say all this. I can feel it. He's like, he's probably thinking, this is so typical of this chick.
He knows you already.
She can't make up her mind. Because that was one of the questions. How quickly do you make decisions? And you know what my answer was?
No. Unsure was your answer.
That was my answer. I was unsure if I make quick decisions or not.
We'll get the psychology assessment on the air straight after this. Ed Sheeran Shivers. Play now. Here at Kiss. 8:15. Morning, guys. Hi, everyone.
Jackie O will undertake a psych assessment.
If you listen to this show long enough, you will realise one of us is mental and the other one quite sane. And depending on who you ask that listens, I'm sure the answer is sometimes you or sometimes me. And
it
mixes around amongst the staff, I think.
Well, we have got Mark Matheson on the phone, and he does all the psych tests for shows like SAS, Survivor, and lets them know kind of what to expect, I'm assuming, about their characters.
Yeah, well, he works for the Army, Special Forces. It's quite an involved test.
Yes.
And Jackie and I have been asked all the questions. Mark has analysed all the data, and he's on the air now. Hey, Mark. Good morning.
Hey, Mark.
Thanks for coming on, buddy.
Good morning. Good morning. Scary results. I'm a bit worried about doing this live on air.
Are you really?
Oh, my God. Okay. Why don't you go with Kyle first and then we'll get to me.
Okay. Yeah, I'm happy to go first. Rip the Band-Aid off. Mm. So, Mark, everyone listening wants to know sort of how many questions and like how do you analyze all this stuff?
Well, look, it's a fairly long process, Kyle. And look, I found it a little bit ironic, Jackie, you said that it was a long test because the actual test we get to the recruits for a lot of these shows to do is probably well over 2 hours. And I think we struggled to get your attention for about 15 minutes. Is that right? So there's a bit of a fail right there from the outset.
But that's true.
But you've got to ask questions to sort of dig underneath what people believe themselves to be as well. This is how you actually get to the truth.
That's what I tried. So I do believe I answered very honestly, even if that was to my detriment with the results.
Same.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, and that shows, Jackie, look, we do have a number of scales built into these tests now to pick up on the fudge factor. I mean, psychologists have been around a while now, so we know that people often try to paint an overly rosy picture.
Yeah.
And so we've got some scales built in, which fortunately you both passed, so that means that the results are reasonably valid. Okay. But look, I think the key point is that you know, we're comparing you in this test with other military personnel. So
we're
trying to predict how you might go in a course like the SAS.
And is this
course.
The lower end of the military or the brigadier general's end where I feel that I should be at the top of the chain there?
Well, in this context, it's comparing you with special forces soldiers. So we're looking for quite a unique and sort of small niche capability, which is different from the rest of the military. And for example, Kyle, I mean, you gave us some results that indicated you'd have some strengths as a special forces soldier.
Oh, is that right? I knew it. Well,
let's park the fitness element.
Oh, yeah.
Let's forget about that for a minute.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
But psychologically, you know, there are some unique characteristics we're looking for, which the test shows. So, for example, Kyle, you know, we found that you score very highly on, you know, creating innovation. So you're an innovative, out of the box sort of thinker, which we need in special forces. We need people to solve complex problems, but terrible at following the rules.
Oh, yes. Yeah, well, I think that everyone would probably agree that is actually right. Yeah, I'm not a big rule follower. I've got anti-authority issues.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if I'd say issues, but but you certainly scored in a very low area on that sort of scale of following rules and following structures, which I think you're
well, who are the assholes that make the rules, and what makes them so good is what I want to know.
See,
well, there
you go.
We go. We've got some evidence right there of of that reactive nature.
Yeah.
Fair enough. I've got to take that on the chin because that's definitely true.
That's right. So, look, if we put you in a context of a special forces sort of selection course, I'd expect you to be the guy who seeks the limelight, who wants to be, you know, up front, being the leader, solving the problems.
Yes.
But you'd probably have a bit of difficulty taking some feedback. You'd probably struggle. You know, it's kind of your way or the highway, which I think would bring you some heat, you know, in a show like SAS Australia.
Oh, for sure.
That little should be on his tiptoes yelling in my face.
And?
Yeah, that little tiny man.
Number nine, what do you think you're doing?
Excuse me, I'd be number one if I went on that show, nine.
He wants to be number one. It makes no difference.
Absolutely, absolutely. So in the limelight, but look, good at communication. So you'd certainly be able to, you know, to convince others of your plan, you know, which in the context of a special forces sort of environment, again, is a positive characteristic. You need to be able to be determined to you know, have a plan and to back yourself to follow that plan.
Right.
It just might be the case that it's not always the right plan. So you might be heading off into the wilderness, you know, hoping that everyone's following you, but perhaps not always.
Leading them all to their intimate death.
potentially.
Was there any other things that stood out, like very bad or very good on all those questions?
Yeah, look, the areas you scored really low on are not the surprising ones, I guess. I mean, being organised, following timelines, sticking to scripts, which I'm sure your producers can back.
There's no scripts here.
Following the rules. And look, clearly, again, in a special forces context, those things aren't always necessarily bad, but, you know, it is still a military environment, so you need to be able to play within the sandpit, so to speak, with enough sort of veracity to be believed. And
what
was
my best results? You've spent way too much time on the negative things. Now, I don't even remember a positive so far.
No, look, it's definitely in the leadership and the convincing people. So you're the lone wolf who's out the front, leading from the front.
Yeah, with no real idea and no real plan.
With no real idea sometimes, but that's okay. I mean, as special forces operatives, they operate in teams. Yeah, so as long as you've got a good 2IC, somebody who's, you know, second in command, who's sort of pulling you back in a little bit and going, hang on, Kyle, we need to slow down a little bit.
Oh, my God, that's what Jackie does to me.
Thank you.
That's how we're so successful here.
Yeah, that's
correct. Absolutely.
Right. Yeah. Well, that makes sense.
That's one of the fundamental elements of all of these assessments is that we never assess people in isolation. It's always a dynamic live environment. So, you know, you've got the influence of other people. It depends on who you're with, who's around you, who's leading you, what the context of the mission is. So,
overall, what do you think of me?
Yeah.
Mental or not mental?
Mental, but the lone wolf. So that's a
the lonely mental wolf is what I am.
That's me. That's you. Yep, absolutely.
And I know that he started with me because they always end with the really bad one
second.
That must really be terrifying, Jackie.
I know. If the producers have put me last, that means mine's worse. I just know it. But we'll wait. We'll wait, okay? We'll take a quick break and then we'll come back with Mark and we'll see what my psych assessment says about me.
Yes, because I've been told this might take quite the time to get through.
Oh, it does. Really?
I don't know. I'm just teasing. Mark, stand by. Try and get through that gigantic pile of the problems that you've got to share with everyone about Jackie. There might be some good things in there, but let's not just assume she's going to be horrible.
Yeah.
And a flip out and a flighty-dighty and like one of those whirly-birdy types. Well, getting back on standby, Jackie's results next, everyone. Yeah, are we crazy? My results came back. We're doing a psych test. The same guy that does the SAS, Survivor, the Army, Special Forces. We sat down, we wrote down, we had answered a heap of questions, Jackie and I.
Yes, and
my results
gone through
came
yours.
Out. Yeah, mine, I'm a natural born leader. I'm just paraphrasing.
I love that's all you've taken from it, is that you're a natural born leader. But really,
he did
say you are a leader, but you're not thinking out what comes next. So you could lead your crew to death.
Yeah. Well, that's the way you see it. I see it as I'm fluid and liquid and, yeah, follow me across the hill, everyone.
Follow me, even though I don't know what I'm doing, but I'll work it out. I'll wing it, guys.
So the guy doing all the analysis for us today is a psychologist. You ready to go with Jackie's? Let's get Mark back on. Hey, Mark. You ready?
Hey, Mark.
You got Jackie's long results there, the big pile of paperwork?
Yeah, sure do. And look, there are some concerns here, Jackie, so I think you should brace yourself.
Oh, no. What concerns?
Oh, get me a biro. I need to write all these down.
Okay, look, again, I think the important point here is to remember that we're predicting how you would go in a special forces or military context. So, look, whilst Kyle might be, you know, very task-focused and leading people off into the wilderness, I think, conversely, I think you're very people-focused, which means there's the tendency to be a bit paralysed in worrying about what other people think.
Oh, that's so true.
Yeah, we have a saying in the army called being the grey man, or obviously in your case, the grey woman.
Yeah.
This is a person who wants to hide in the crowd a bit, you know, wants to sort of go with the flow, not really prepared to put themselves out the front. So that means you tend to have a bit of selective hearing, tend to sort of just hear the things that you want to hear.
Yeah.
That allow you to kind of blend in and not really stand out. Look, so you're great at reading the room, great at focusing on those teamwork aspects and making sure you're fitting in and being socially accepted, but to the detriment of actually getting the job done. So that's going to be a real problem for you on selection courses or in a military context. Obviously great in a social sort of context. Or
oh, she's great
life.
With a wine and ciggy, make no mistake.
Absolutely, yeah, for sure. So a total team player, loves the team, loves understanding how people tick, is probably going to be the person that sort of floats around in the background and tries to get to know people. Unfortunately, not particularly good at letting people know her. So probably a bit standoffish, you know, wants to kind of keep some of that stuff that hidden.
Oh, yeah. Jackie, this is you to a T.
Yeah, yeah. I need to get to know people before I can, you know, build a rapport. So, yes.
Yep. Want to make sure that you fit in. So maybe lacks a little bit of confidence in that sort of step forward, put yourself in the limelight sort of space.
For sure.
Writing down bullet points, not confident. what else is it? Yeah, keep going. I'll come right.
Yeah,
all this down.
Bit disorganized, you know, hang tends on, to focus on the social dynamic. So the task stuff is just not going to happen. Look, you can make a great second in command. So, you know, you probably work well with someone like Kyle.
Yep.
And that means that you know, focus on repairing all the damaged relationships that he leaves in his wake.
Yes. Oh, my God. That is exactly right.
She spent her life doing
that. That's my whole job.
Absolutely.
Wow.
So, look, I think you would struggle significantly in a military space because you'd want that sort of positive reinforcement from both the other recruits and also the DS.
Oh, I wouldn't be getting that from the DS.
That's exactly right. So there's going to be a huge negative space there, which is going to, I think, get inside your head and you're going to ruminate over that massively, whereas Kyle's probably going to be completely oblivious to those sorts of things and just charge on regardless.
Correct. Wow. That is absolutely true.
He's nailed us there, right?
Yeah, you have. Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
Is there any other red flags there? Because I'm thinking Jackie's like one of those car yards on Parramatta Road having a sale. Red flags everywhere, flapping in the wind. You know what I mean?
Yeah, look, the big one is really just that lack of mission focus. So in the context of the military, you know, not really hearing the complete mission, just sort of focusing on the bits of information that reinforce her social setting and not really being able to focus on the bigger picture and solve the problems. So probably just going to be a bit of a wallflower, I'm afraid, Jackie, and just float along with the group.
A wallflower? Nobody wants to be called a wallflower.
No,
I didn't know this was for SAS, though. I thought you were the SAS psych guy, but I thought this was just a general, like, you know, psych analysis. I reckon if push came to shove and I had to do the SAS course, I think, you know, some of these answers would be different because you just have to step up. You have to. And when you have to, I would. But if I don't have to, I won't.
That's not how your results came back. Your results came back is that you're a wallflower, unconfident, not organised, and a number two.
But cares a lot about other people, reading the room,
so
how
what?
They feel.
What's that do? What's that done for you?
Yeah, what does that mean? What would you say that means?
Just means that you're going to be the team morale, the person who keeps morale high when things are chips are down, and that's a really important attribute.
That's
again, it's
important
team based.
Yep.
Okay. Is it though? Sure. Is it important for your own self-preservation, or is that important for the team's preservation?
Well, it's both for military. You really got it. You can't just be a one-man band. You got to be, you know, it's a team.
Well, what happens if everyone else gets killed? What happens then?
You're the one-man band.
I'm ready for that.
Oh, but see, I would be killed already.
She'd be first killed, right?
Probably.
Might be the weakest link.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Now, Jackie, did you expect those results?
A little bit when it comes to, if you're looking at it from an SAS point of view, 100% I expected that.
It also says I don't know why he hasn't mentioned this. It says her time management is poor, which will have major impact on the rest of her crew. You're less organized, structured compared to others, and prefer not to have a clear plan for the future.
Oh, see, when I was asked that, again, I was not thinking SAS. I was just thinking, I don't ever plan for the future in life. I just go with the flow and let's see what happens. It's how I always have been. But there's nothing wrong with that in your day-to-day life, right?
Absolutely. And look, I guess the reality of these tests is that they are designed to predict your behaviours in a very specific environment.
Right. Yeah.
Look, the context of a selection course, let's say it's SAS or even Survivor for that matter, is we're trying to erode those social sort of external faces that we put on in everyday life, because we've got the luxury of going home, getting sleep and, you know, refueling the system and coming back to work the next day with a smiley face on. Whereas in a military context, that gets worn away pretty quick. So the physicality of the course erodes all that social nicety and we get down to raw character. So raw character is what happens when the chips are down, yeah? Not so much when you go to work every day.
So at her core, she's all these things, regardless whether it's military or social.
Yeah, but doesn't mean she can't do them.
As a human, though, very caring for others, and she thinks about others before herself. I think that's nice.
Pretty much. Yep, yeah. Absolutely.
And me, I think only about myself, and I will destroy and squash anyone that stands in the road. Is that about accurate?
So you're the task-focused guy who's going to focus on the mission, and Jackie's the people-focused person who's going to worry about the team.
And together, that's why we're successful.
Correct. Don't you think it's all summed up by when you guys came here to KISS and Kyle said, we're doing this, you know, it's going to work out, follow me, let's go. Yeah. And Jackie was like, oh, you know, I don't know about this.
I've got a mortgage and a family.
And even on their last day at Today FM, Kyle was out the door and there's Jackie making sure everyone was okay afterwards.
That's true.
Oh, my God, it's so accurate.
Yeah. That's true. They became the enemy and I still stayed to see if they were okay. And I would be killed if that was the military.
Yeah, that's right. Where I was driving out of the garage in the Rolls Royce, I should have thrown a grenade into that joint when I left. Hey, look, man, that's fascinating. What a great job you've got. How long do you have to study at TAFE for that?
TAFE?
Oh, whatever. Yeah. It's a uni thing, not a TAFE thing. It's more of a hairdresser's course.
Exactly. So, look, as a registered psychologist, we spent about 6 years at uni, but, look, there's nothing that sort of replaces the school of life in working with people. So I've been very fortunate to work with lots and lots of, high-functioning people and learn, I guess, through, you know, just seeing the trends and seeing what people are like.
Imagine being his wife or girlfriend. Imagine you'd never win an argument. He'd be psychoanalyzing you every step of the way. Do you struggle with personal relationships?
No. See, my partner's an anaesthetist, so she just threatens to put me to sleep if I get too smart.
Oh, it works so brilliantly, though.
She every has time, the upper hand.
Every time he gets a little bit smart arsey, she pulls the needle out.
So she does, and she threatens to do it when I'm asleep, so it's like I won't even know it's happening.
How terrifying. I love that.
So, Mark, if you had to pick one of us, who is more mentally unstable?
Oh. Look, I think it would have to be you, Jackie. Sorry.
Well done.
Sorry.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Well done. As predicted by all of us.
Why am I mentally unstable? What makes me
even
unstable?
Even crying and yelling, why am I mentally unstable? That answers your question, yeah, doesn't it?
But am I mentally unstable?
No, of course not. But look, I think in the context of a selection course or a military environment, I think you'd struggle more than Kyle.
Yeah.
But look, I don't know. That's certainly not mentally unstable in the context of, you know, pathology, but yeah, look, I think you'd find that very hard and probably.
Well, we don't need to go into semantics. She's the mental one. We heard what he said.
Don't. He's going to start. He'll never forget this and he'll throw it out every time. Thank you so much, Mark.
Pleasure.
We appreciate it.
What a fascinating job that guy's got.
So Kyle could go on the SAS program, you believe?
Yep. I look forward to seeing both of
you
guys against that.
Never, never, ever. Do you know why? Because this last one that just happened, when they went in the wormhole, that little tight pipe under the ground.
Yeah.
Like, I wouldn't have even got my shoulders in that bloody pipe, and I would have been jammed, and I can't do that. That was, I really felt for all those celebrities on that show.
They're horrific challenges, aren't they?
Yeah, remember, they Jackie, remember Jackie and I, remember we were going to abseil off the bloody Novotel building? Remember we were going to do that?
And tell Mark what happened.
I got all wobbly and nearly started crying and said I couldn't do it.
And then what happened?
And then you parasailed down like you were a professional.
I stepped up to the challenge, Mark, and I did it on his behalf.
But you know why I didn't do it? It wasn't really fear of me not being able to do it. It was the fear of the you know, the extreme sports dude that was putting all the ropes together, and I looked at him and thought, you've been on acid for sure in the last month.
No, that's Kyle. See, this and is I Kyle's thought, excuse.
The rope won't fit. The rope's
he
not going to work.
He was scared. He was like this. He was like this, Mark. Oh, okay, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. Get me up. Get me up.
That's true.
And then I was like, I'll do it. I'll do it. And what? I just did it.
Yeah,
boom.
Yeah, right.
But so I'd say, Kyle, you were worried about the outcome. You've got to be successful. Jackie, you were worried about the peer pressure to perform. So the peer pressure won out.
Oh,
that's so true.
God, I win again. Even when I thought I failed, I won. I'm unbelievable. Thank the stars, it's Friday. Yeah, we are on a Friday. That means we're going to play What's in Jackie's Mouth. She sticks something in.
Yep.
She gives us clues all through mumbling whatever this thing
Whatever's in the mouth, yeah.
Whoever gets it wins the prize. You'll win $500 to spend at Key sunglasses and blue light glasses. They suit any style. You can shop right now at keyaustralia.com.au.
Okay, guys, call up for it if you want to play 131065.
Our DJ over in Los Angeles who works at our KISS affiliate station, KISS 102.7, he's ready to do the mega mix for us. He'll be back at lunchtime with a full rundown too with Gordy. Right now, it's a mini mix right here on a Friday at KISS.
What's in Jackie's mouth? Never waste a trip.
If you want to ring and line up to play, guess what's in Jackie's mouth? Well, you're shit out of luck because the phone board, I've never seen more calls than are on there now.
It's so
I got a whole computer screen and it's every call that we, and we got a lot of numbers here. They're all full.
You
got it in there?
I certainly do.
Well, Jesus, that sounds pretty intense.
It's full.
You got a lot of space there? Can you, no.
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, yeah, I can hear you. Okay, yeah. If you want to play 131065, the prize is the $500 to spend at Key Sunglasses, keyaustralia.com.au. Let's get Chris from Yaguna on. Hey, buddy, you're first in line. Good morning.
Hello.
Chris.
Chris?
He's not there.
All right, go to Jason.
Oh, there he is. Go back. Is. Yeah, sorry, must have been listening in delay. Chris, sorry, we nearly missed you, buddy. How are you?
Yeah, not bad, guys. How are you guys?
Very good. Okay, now, Jackie, would you like to give Chris a clue as to what's in your mouth?
Yeah, this can have a really weird smell if you're not used to it.
A really weird smell. Is it the, you know, that thing that they put, the dentist put in your mouth, that thing that opens the teeth together?
Oh, the clamp thing. Yeah, I've seen those in a few dungeons.
Yeah, no, it's not that. Sorry, Chris.
Oh.
Feeling.
Gee, that's harsh. Feeling. Jason and Rose Lee, hello. What's going on there,
I think there's too many calls, Kyle. It's lagging the
Jason,
system.
Are you there? Jason. From Roselle. Oh, there he is. There he is. Sorry, man.
Okay, Jace. Here's your next clue. People either love or hate having this in their mouth.
I'm going to say papaya.
Papaya! Is it papaya?
Papaya! No, no, not papaya.
Move on to the next one.
Okay, all right.
Maddie, hello.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, how you going?
Good, buddy. Here's good. A clue for you.
When I was a little kid, I would never put this in my mouth. But now that I'm an adult, I've grown to love having it in my mouth.
God, that could be anything. Who knows what that is?
Is it a loofah?
A what?
A loofah?
A loofah, yeah.
A loofah, no, like what you wash yourself in the shower with.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I love a loofah, in all honesty.
But it really gets the suds going, doesn't it?
I like the suds of a loofah, but I insist that the colour of the loofah must match the bathroom it's in.
So
nothing.
White.
I've got like a stone bathroom, right? And then the missus always buys the pink or the. It doesn't work. It doesn't match
I
the
agree.
Bathroom.
You've got to have matching.
Sorry, like Louise. It. Hello, Louise. Sorry. How are you?
Hi, Carl. Hi, Jackie. How are you?
Hey, hon. Good. Here's good. A clue for you.
Quite often this lives in a dark environment.
Quite often you live in a dark environment.
Mm.
What's that, Louise?
Oh, my goodness. Well, I was going to guess toothpaste, but that doesn't relate to that now.
Well, maybe it does, because doesn't the toothpaste live in a bathroom drawer?
Oh, it does, yeah. So,
you know, her clues are pretty loose.
I'm gonna go toothpaste.
Is it toothpaste, Jackie?
No, not toothpaste.
I led you down the garden path, sorry. I was so convinced. Jesse.
Hey, Jess.
Good morning.
Hey, how you going?
Good, bro. Clue for Jackie. Please, Jackie, give Jesse.
Look, my whole life I've had white ones in my mouth, but I'm ready for some brown ones.
Wow, who would have thought?
I've heard the brown ones are tastier.
Is that right?
Mm.
Any idea there, Jesse, what's in Jackie's mouth?
No.
Used to having white ones in there, but now she feels she's ready to put a brown one in there. Yeah.
Mm.
I'm going to have a very vague guess, and is it mouthwash?
Mouthwash? The brown mouthwash?
The brown mouthwash sounds gross. No.
No, right. It's not right, Jess. Thanks for playing. Joanne in Narrowing. Hello.
Hello.
Hey there.
Hey.
Yeah, here's a clue.
It has quite a bulbous-shaped head on it.
Bulbous-shaped head?
Yep.
Any idea there, Joanne?
Now you threw me right off. I had something there.
Well, what were you going to say? I won't count that. What were you going to say?
I was going to say, you know, the guard you put in your mouth to whiten your teeth.
The what? Oh, the
guard.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't want him to be put brown ones in there, you know?
Who wants to have junky-looking teeth? No one.
Yeah.
That'd be a whole new thing.
You better be quick, guys. I'm eating this, and it's dissolving.
Is that? Oh, there's another clue, really, Joanne. What do you think's in there?
Oh, dissolving.
It's dissolving in her mouth.
And like I said, it has quite a bulbous, mushroom-shaped head.
All right. What do you think that is, Joanne?
Is it a... denture tablet.
Is it a denture tablet, Jackie? No, it's not a denture tablet.
No, it's not.
Joanne was 60, so she's just looking around the room there.
Yeah.
James in Spring Farm. You're on. Hey, James.
Hey.
Hey, guys.
Hey, buddy. Another clue for James, please, Jackie.
Yeah, it's quite soft and bendy.
Like soft.
Kind of bendy.
What?
Is it a mushroom?
It is a mushroom. Oh, I said it has a mushroom head.
Shelby Spear and James, you got it. $500. You can go a little shopping spree at sunglasses and blue light key sunglasses and blue light glasses. They suit any style. You need the glasses because we're allowed out, everyone, as of Monday. Thank the Lord.
Oh, hallelujah.
Awesome.
Man, nice work. You're looking good.
Thank you, James.
Awesome.
Hi, buddy. The diary up next being Friday with the best on and off the air. We'll get some last calls on Jack. He'll give us some O news. All that's coming up.
Friday, then Saturday, Sunday.